standing naked in her room, lights in front of her full-length mirror. She is looking into it, not seeing her well-shaped body, her double-toned complexion, well-shaped rear, and her small standing breasts. What she saw was frightening, embarrassing. She wanted to run. She tried, but her feet was not moving. She could not scream. She was forced, compelled to watch. There, she saw herself crying in her bed, praying, asking why. Feeling unloved, not worthy to exist in that world. The color of her skin has made her an alien in her home. Being told you are not black, you are not one of us. She tries to comfort herself that she is white. This has made her more of a mocking symbol in her home. That night, she was committed to drink that liquid in that bottle. They won't miss her. Fortunately or unfortunately, she slept through the night. She wants to move, but her body parts have rusted. Tears in her eyes, the little girl is crying once more. Her innocence is being taken away too early by one she knows too well. Why must she be told she lies? She would rip apart that loving family. She means nothing to them, to him, to her father. He left without looking back. So why would another man want her if she is not pleasing to him? At this time, she's conscious. She's naked in front of the mirror. Why is she seeing this? Another person she is today. Who is this little girl? As if she was reading her mind, the little girl speaks. I am you. I am here to wake you up. Stop the feeling of sorrow. Remember where you have come from. The trials you have overcome. The people you have helped, and will help. You are an African woman coming from a bloodline of strength, endurance, and true love. You are a daughter, sister, mother. You have lived a life to make me proud, supported and encouraged by all your siblings, loving, teaching, nurturing, protecting the future leaders, motivator, crown princess. The little girl fades, saying, love yourself, love yourself, love yourself. I can
I think I might. I still remember your face, the way you laugh, the way you taste. Written on my wall in a variety of colors, your first, your middle, and your last, with its flowers. And I think I can, I think I might fall in love with you tonight. Even though I feel so weak, I won't give up the fight, 'cause I never wanted anything as badly as I do want you. And you don't even know it, but I do.
That I did before. It's called I Want a Love. I want a love that tosses me head over heels and under. One that is found in novels and drowned my troubles, and sets my thoughts in tune with the rhythm of my partner. I want a love that is painless, boundless, fearless, and sober. I want a love that would make me laugh and cry on any note and anywhere, and cry a river flow of happiness and joy. A love that shows and glows from my hair follicles to my toenails. I want a love that is protected and respected. One that shows hope of a silver lining when all that surrounds is a dark cloud, like the shimmer of moonshine on timid ocean waves, or the incense of fragrant candles that entices the senses even at a stunted, crooked end. I want a love that is real, a love that cures and heals, cures and heals, cures and heals when my thoughts are in a mess. One without condition or bitterness, only the wild, secure tumble of volcanic emotion. And through my pen should trickle verses of pure insight. I want a love that is right. Build me new wings to fly, so at times when I can't walk, I'll soar to the sky. A love that is instinctive, addictive, and faithful. A love that makes music with consonants. As the slow, rhythmic beat of the drum sink into the melody of soft strings on a Spanish guitar against the harmony of an old polished flute. I want a love that is equal, for even as we're mute,
and even as we're asleep, our hearts must beat to the heat of a song eternal.
They're not too high maintenance, but they got nice toes, and we like nice toes, man. Who don't like nice toes?